we were sitting there fishing, and I heard a noise and turned around and looked and seen some blue lights, some hazy blue lights. And that's when, you know, the craft landed behind us. We still wasn't for sure what it was, but it landed, and we turned around, and the front of it opened up. And when it did, it was just like we were paralyzed there. For he couldn't move and I couldn't move, but there's three robot looking creatures that floated out. They didn't walk, they just kind of glided out of the craft and come over, and two got a hold of me and one got a hold of Charlie, and they took us inside. They did an examination. So when they examined us, we was probably in there, I'm gonna say 45 minutes. I'm not real sure. I didn't have a watch or nothing at the time. They put us back out at the same place we were, facing the water, and I was froze, you know, in one spot. And originally, I didn't want to talk about it no more, so Charlie just said, you know, play like you passed out in there and you won't have to say nothing too much. So that's what I did. I kind of went along with that. Charlie said it was probably 40 foot. I remember more like a 90 foot long, kind of an oblong shape. And it had a bluish tint to it and two blue lights on the front of it. When it took off, it didn't make hardly any noise at all. You just heard like a zipping noise. It was zip, and that was it, and it was gone. And it shattered the windows in my car. I had a brand new 1973 Hornet Rambler.
Took them down there and put them in a room with a voice activated mic, and it's hidden in the desk to see what they'd say. Well, me and the other investigator got up and left to let them talk to see if they was going to say, well, we got them fooled and all. They didn't. They were really concerned. The boys kept telling Charles, don't talk to them and people's going to come back and get us.